Welcome again, everyone, to the second part of Campus Corner. Now we are in one of the most famous spots in the engineering building, the green benches. Whenever you get lost in the building, just tell your friend, like, I'm near the green benches. They find you right away. I have conducted a study on the people who sit here. I categorized them into four categories. The first category is the person who comes here to actually study. They have headphones on and they start studying like there is no tomorrow. The second group of people, they come here in groups. One of them is really active, moving from one side to another. There is one guy teaching the others. The third group are a group of people who they don't have books or papers and they just hang out here. The fourth category are the lovebirds. You can see them like sitting awkwardly, acting like they're studying. When you get close to them, they stop talking no matter what they were discussing. At the end of my study on the types of people who uses the green benches, I found out that computational engineers, they usually fall in the first category. I have some tips for you when you come here. First thing, take it seriously. The studies here are not really difficult, but you really need to manage your time and take it seriously. The second tip is that this is an international course. So please try to be international. Don't stick to a group from your country or who speaks the same language. Just mingle around. The third and the last tip is that to always ask for help, either in academics, like you can ask your professor, your friends, or you can always go to the computational support office and they will always help you. My favorite memory in computational engineering, maybe the first one, is the welcome day, the Berlin trip. We have like a yearly big trip with everybody in CompEng, and a ski trip in winter. That was also like a very nice experience. If you want to know more about what we do in computational engineering, mainly the trips and activities, you can always visit the website. You will find there some pictures and written articles about what we usually do in these trips.
Happy and proud to welcome you at our University Bochum. My name is Jörg Sahlmen. I'm the general coordinator of our CompEng course. I started my career as academics here at our University Bochum in the year 1986. For you, it is decades ago. And I finished around 92, 93 my studies in mechanical engineering and started directly at the chair of wind engineering, a new job in the winter. After a decade, I changed to CompEng coordination, that was in 2007, and we started to redesign our course, which started in 2000. In 2007, we decided to renew it, to modernize it, to build up a new curriculum, to look for new colleagues, for new courses, for new ideas, to be more modern. And step by step, we did that over the last 13 years. And up to now, we have a status where we think we are best in the world. In 2010, additionally, I got the position of CEO of a tunneling research center here at our faculty. In this tunneling research center, we have 35 doctorates. From the 35 doctorates, 23 are coming from CompEng. They are CompEng alumni. It was a good flow from studies to PhD for many of your former CompEng colleagues. So coming to the nice place, the nicest place at university, especially for me, it's my office, because in my office I live more or less the half of my life, daily life. If you have a look through the window, you directly understood why I really like to be here in my office and to work on CompEng things, on the tunneling things, to have visitors, to have discussion with CompEng students, to staff, and so on and so on. Let's come to some specialities in my office. I have a CompEng museum. You can see here in the backside, having souvenirs from Yemen, from Vietnam, from Iran, from India, from Pakistan, and all these things attend me in the day, and they give me luck to fulfill my job here as best. There's a second museum in my office, and that deals with football. Is the club of Borussia Dortmund, next by. The stadium is around 10 to 15 kilometers away. A hill is hiding it, but I can see it from my office. I can tell you that the Ruhr area is enthusiastic for football. On Monday, everybody's discussing football. My experience was in the last year that the former colleagues of CompEng also have been fans after a while for one of the teams here in the war area, and I hope that will be enjoy you in future.
I'm Xuling Ye, and I just finished studying computational engineering. Now I'm a PhD student in chair computing in engineering from Professor Koenig, which you would have some courses from him. My background is computer science, so I'm doing more related to programming work. And in our chair, we had a lot of PhD students also from computer science background. And now I'm doing something related to building information modeling combining with blockchain. So now we are in the university garden where you can visit for free. In this garden, there's a lot of different plants, and there's also bench where you can sit on. And there's also see this lake, it's really beautiful, you can visit. We also have a lot of greenhouses and also the Chinese garden where we will visit later. The most surprising courses for me was machine learning and high performance computing, because I never expect these two courses would be in computational engineering major. What I expected was computational engineering should be more related to civil engineering and mechanical engineering, but these courses are really advanced computer science, which I really like. Now we are in the Chinese garden. This garden already built 20 years. This is a really beautiful garden which you can have a walk around. You can see a lot of rockets, waterfalls, and rivers with, not river, but lake, with a plant on it and fish. And also the small garden which you can sit and maybe study, take a rest there. The tip I want to give you for studying computational engineering is, firstly, you need to study a little bit harder at the first and the second semester. Even, for example, my background is computer science, but I still can pass all the courses, and I even got a scholarship at the third semester. So just don't worry, but you still need to study harder. And at the third semester, there are more optional courses which you can choose, and you can choose whatever you're interested in or you're good at. If you can't finish your study at fourth semester, you still can delay a little bit. You can write your master's thesis at the fifth semester. Do not be panicked, and good luck for your study.